AstraZeneca temporarily suspending final testing of its potential vaccine. Patient in the United Kingdom experiencing a spinal inflammatory disorder. Company CEO reportedly confirming the patient was injected with the vaccine and not a placebo. Looks like the patient will make a full recovery.
Joining us now to talk about the vaccine concerns is Dr. Manu Jaine from Northwestern Medicine. Doctor, thank you so much for being here. Let's put this into context. Any reason to be concerned, or are they following the right path here?
No, I think that what they're doing is appropriate. You have a very large trial with up to 30,000 people. You're going to have adverse events that happen at a low frequency, and I think they're doing the right thing in stopping the trial and evaluating it and seeing if it's related to the vaccine or not, and then going forward if it's appropriate.
Well, Doctor, you have to agree that with hearing this, it could deter some people from getting a vaccine, because this person was injected, he was otherwise healthy, right? This person was injected with a vaccine and with complications that kind of people want to put on the brakes and don't want to try a vaccine once it is approved.
No, you're right. This is a study of healthy volunteers. So this person was healthy and volunteered to enter the trial and now has had a adverse event. And so it does give us a pause. And I think the trial planners are doing the right thing. I think when you're looking at any vaccines, you have to balance the risks and benefits, and that really can't be evaluated fully until all the trial results are in, and we can see what the efficacy has been and what the side effects have been. And so I think we have to just wait and be patient until all the results are in.
Doctor, we're still hearing more about this patient. Do you have any insight as to what happened exactly? And then how do they draw that nexus that it may have directly, definitely been caused by this vaccine?
Well, I don't know very much about the adverse event that occurred with this volunteer. The data is reviewed by the DSMB, which is the Data Safety Monitoring Board, and they evaluate when the vaccine was given, what the effects were in terms of timing, and have all the clinical parameters around this sort of side effect. And then they adjudicate and they determine whether it's a likely event, unlikely, and make a determination as to whether the trial can go forward.
And doctor, is this an example of how we need to be more patient and let all the trials go through, not rush things, because there are complications possibly?
Absolutely. You know, I think that one of the big concerns that has arisen is how fast these trials are going. And in some ways, it's somewhat heartening that they did halt the trial to make sure it's safe and evaluate this adverse event fully before they go forward. So I think we all just need to take our time and make sure this is going to be safe and efficacious when it becomes available to us.
Presumably, other patients were given that same vaccine, right, doctor?
Yes, yes. This is a placebo-controlled study. And so patients get either the vaccine or placebo. You know, some side effects occur at a very low rate. You don't pick them up unless you enroll 1,000 people, 5,000 people, 10,000 people. And that's why you do these large phase 3 studies to see what the incidence is of these low frequency events. And this will give us a lot of information about that.
It's interesting, and this is on another note, doctor, the flu vaccine. They're telling us to take the flu vaccine earlier this year. Do you suggest that people do take the flu vaccine, and how difficult will it be to determine whether you have the flu this year or COVID?
Well, you know, there's a lot of overlap in terms of the symptoms that can occur with flu and with COVID. Now, we have testing, which is pretty sensitive and specific with respect to delineating whether it's a flu or a COVID that is causing your symptomatology. So it should be picked up, you know, whether it's flu or COVID, if you get the appropriate testing performed.
All right, doctor. Thank you so much. Be safe. Be well.
Thank you. Appreciate it.